मॉर्निंग ऑल आर यू, वेलकम टू अवर कॉलेज शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी पॉलिटेक्निक एड्रा डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी. टुडे इज ऑन स्टार्ट 11th लेक्चर ऑन कोर्स दैट इज सब्जेक्ट अप्लाइड मल्टीमीडिया टेक्निक्स. हियर विजन मिशन स्टेटमेंट ऑफ अवर डिपार्टमेंट. Departmental vision statement is there to excel in information technology engineering education to produce professionally competent engineers with lifelong learning attitude for accomplishment of ever growing needs of society and industry. Departmental mission statement is there to provide quality education through effective teaching learning methodologies with simulating environment for preparing technical and professional competent engineering to build up professional skills in students that will help them to succeed and progress in their personal and professional career. Third one is that to embed professional ethics and social responsibilities in students for society and environment. Syllabus for there are 5 units are there. In that, unit number 1 and unit number 2 is already completed it. Now we start the on today's lecture, we start the new chapter, new unit number 3, web page development using multimedia. Course outcomes. What is meant by course outcomes? After the completion of course, which COs we achieve. Okay, so unit number 3, after the completion of unit number 3, we achieve the which CO? CO 3, build website with multimedia contents. Unit number 3, so unit name is web page development using multimedia. Unit outcomes. Which are the outcomes of after the completion of unit 3A? Write steps to develop web page comparison of graphical media or HTML composer for the given situation. 2B, describe features of the given audio file format. See difference between the two types of audio. Describe features of given video file format. Okay, summary on in previous lecture, in a last lecture in a unit number 2, last in a last point is completed which point? Effects in its image effects. Okay. On today's lecture we start the unit number 3 new chapter, that is web page development using multimedia. Means what? What we create? We create the web pages. Means we build the website. Okay. You know all in your previous like in a previous semester, okay? In a second semester you studied the subject HTML. Okay. In HTML you create the different websites, and in websites we create the web pages. Okay. There all theory parts is used in this subject in under the unit number 3. Means in short, unit number 3 means you are in your last semester HTML subject is a in this considered as a unit number 3. But in that only in your practical session 3 or 4 practicals are there. In that practicals we create the web page. Okay, and means we create the web pages means what? We create the website. Okay, what is meant by website? Collection of web pages is said as the website, and in that new points is added. In that practically depends on the how to audio file and video files are added in a HTML in a web pages. That are practical session that you in your this unit number 3. Clear that? Means in short, unit number 3, which points we discuss? We discuss the language HTML. Okay, and in that additional point is that how to display the audio and video on that web page, that are also in this chapter is added. Okay. So this subject you already learned in a previous semester, but in now again that repeated it, because in your class in a SYIT class the additional students are there, means the direct secondary students and also the in branch changes students are there. So I'm again that taken in a short I'm taking that points means HTML language. Okay, not in a details are studied, only for which points are used in your practical session that points are learned. Okay, means all points are clear, but in a only for in a short means what? You are clear that point. Okay, this only for outcome in that. Okay, so now on today's lecture we start the new chapter. Okay, new point, that introduction to HTML. And this subject, this HTML language also is all are familiar with it. Okay, because all our websites are open, all our websites are seen that. Okay, so these are the means in that HTML which points are there that all are you familiar with. So not any difficulties for that understanding. Okay, it is easy for understanding. Now, web page. What is my web page? A web page is document commonly written in a HTML. HTML, the long form is that hypertext markup language that is accessible through the internet or other networks using an internet browser. Okay. What is my web page? Web page is the document. Okay. What is a web page? Web page means the document commonly written in a HTML that is accessible through the internet or any other networking. Web page is accessible by entering URL address and may contain text, graphics and hyperlinks to the web page and files. Clear that? What is meant by web page? How to web page is accessible? Using to URL through. Okay, URL address to. What is meant by URL? URL long form is Uniform Resource Locator. Okay. On that web page, what is the contents are there? Text or graphics or hyperlinks. What, after that, what is my web browser? All are already known. What is meant by web browser? Web browser are software programs that enables users to view the pages and material on the World Wide Web, the internet-based system of interlinked contents. Okay. Means what is meant by web browser? Web browser is one of software programs that enables users to view the pages. For example, Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Opera, Internet Explorer, etc. What is my website? Website is a collection of related web pages including multimedia content typically identified with common domain name and published on at least one web server. Okay. For example, wikipedia.org. Okay. Org, it is a domain. .com is a domain. Means what is my domain? Domain name. Using through domain name that identify which type of that website. .org means it is the organization website. .com is commercial, that's like. Okay. Website is a collection of related web pages that may contain text, images, audio and video. Okay. The first page of the website is called as home page. In US, in a HTML subject, you create all are done the project. On that pages we create the home page. So first pages of website is said as the home page. Each website has specific internet address, that is URL, that you need to enter in your browser to access the website. Okay. Website is managed by its owner, that can be individual, company or any organization. There are two types of website. Two types? Static website and dynamic website. What is in my static website? Static website is in that no any changes on that websites are said as the static. Dynamics means what? In that changes on that website, that is said as the dynamic. That word is indicated. Its word is indicate that what is static means constant. Dynamic means changes. Okay. HTML language is the static website. It is the example of static website. Okay. Why? Because through HTML language, through we create the website on that no any changes for that web pages. But in a dynamic websites, on that changes on that website. Okay. For example, PHP, CSS language are used. Okay. Under this, through created the websites are said as the dynamic websites. Okay. For a simple example, static website means only for seeing the data. For example, your book. In a book, only for you turn the pages, only for seeing that text, images, that's like the same like a HTML. Okay, dynamic means on the changes. For example, your student registration form, on that student registration form, you filling the data and we submit that are stored in a database. So, and any result on that web pages, then display using to display button, that data will be displayed on that your web page. That's said as the dynamic website. Clear that? Static means what and dynamic means what? Static means constant website only for seeing, only for you front of your eyes. No any changes on that web pages. In the dynamic means on that web pages changes will be possible. Clear? After that, what is HTML? HTML stand for Hypertext Markup Language. HTML is standard markup language for creating web pages. Which purpose to use the language? For creating web pages. HTML describes the structure of web page. HTML consists of series of elements. HTML elements tell the browser how to display the content. Okay? Means what HTML elements tells that. What is the purpose of HTML elements? That browser to how to display the content. In a browser how to display the content are shown. HTML elements label piece of content such as is a heading, sorry, this is a heading, this is a paragraph, this is a link, etc. Where that means what HTML elements label pieces of the content, means in that HTML elements you also use the headings, paragraphs or any links, etc. This is a HTML page structure. Okay, in a HTML language how to write the code. You also learn the C language, and also in this semester also seen that data structure using C and OOP. Okay, in that any one format is are there to how to write the code. This same thing in a HTML language also format is there. In through format we write the code. Okay, means these are the tag. It is said as the tag. Okay, in that tag, how to write the tag in a less than operator, and it is a greater than operator. Okay, use that. It is also said as the angular bracket. It is the opening angular bracket, is the closing angular bracket. Okay, in that angular brackets we write the title name, your tag name, that is HTML element name. Okay, these are your HTML page structure. In that said as the first tag. Okay. It is exclamatory mark, DOC type HTML. What is meaning that? Declaration defines that this document is an HTML file document. Okay. What is the said as? Sorry, HTML document. Okay. What is the said? DOC. In that, the DOC means document type. Okay. Using these lines through, what is the declaration? This is the document type of HTML. After that, this tag, which is also known as a tag or also said as the element HTML. Okay, this is the root element of the HTML page. After that, head element contains meta information about the HTML page. Okay, what is my meta? Meta means data about data. Okay. And again, how to write that HTML element in that angular brackets. Okay, this is the opening angular bracket, is the closing angular brackets. In between, you write your element name. After that, next, title. Okay, in that HTML head body. Title element specifies the title for the HTML page, which is shown in your browser title bar or in the page tab. Okay, this elements is used for specify the title for your HTML page. Okay, you use mobile, all are used a mobile. Okay, all are used the different websites are opening. On that website, any one web page when you open that time their page title will be displayed on a above of your left side. Okay, that is the said as the title. In your notebook or in your book also the titles are there. Okay, so it is possible in also in a HTML how to give the title using the title element. After that, body element defines the document's body. Means what? At is a container for all the visible contents, which are visible contents on a web pages that are right in a body element, or also said in a body tag. such as headings, paragraph, images, hyperlinks, tables, lists, etc. Okay. After that, next H1 elements are also said as a tag defines a large heading. After that, P elements defines a paragraph. Okay. Means in short, this is the DOC type HTML is said as the this is the your HTML document page. After that, HTML start. HTML means your HTML language code is start. Head, in between the head, what is the said? In her head, that maintains the meta information about the HTML, means data about data. Okay, in this the HTML is the root element. Okay, this the HTML is the root element. Head, okay, this head is the data about data. In that head, title is data. In a head, the data is title, and in the another data. Okay, so this said as the metadata about the info about the your web page. Using to title, in that web page title is this word is sorry this is a sentence will be displayed in your title as of that web page, and that it is a closing tag. Okay, in that said as it is a opening tag, it is the closing tag. Okay, after that body. Is opening tag, it is closing tag. Okay, in that body, actually which contents are displayed on that web page, that will be written in a body tag. After that, your HTML code, sorry, HTML close, your root element is close or end. Clear that? And in a end, in a start, and it is the end. It is a start tag, it is the end tag. Okay, in that difference is that how to say as it is a start or it is an end. Because in that end tag is the forward slash are there. Using through this it is indicate that it is the end tag, closing tag, etc. Okay, clear? How to write the structure? What is the structure of your HTML page structure? Okay, means in a C how to write the variable declaration, header files, what is my main function, what is my get stage, what is my printf function, scanf. Okay, these are like this same like in a HTML also. These are the main structure of your HTML tag. First of all, declare the this statement is said as the your this document is will be HTML. After that, this is the HTML start and it is the your root element. After that, head and body, these are the two parts in their HTML. In that head, what is the return which for the meta information means in for your web page in any information we giving means in your title etc. But it is not a display in a your web page, not a in a writing a content. Okay, when you want to content will be displayed on a web page, then that will be written in a body tag. Okay, using through H1P. H1 is the heading tag. P means paragraph. Like, okay, again we next to you that I'm saying that. Okay, and also you that all are learning in your previous semester also. After that, this is clear there. Next point, HTML element. What is my HTML element? An HTML element is defined by a start tag, some contents, and an end tag. Clear that? I'm saying as start tag, end tag, like it is a tag name. Okay, this said as the tag name or also element. It's a head, HTML, title. It is a said as the tag name. Contents goes here. That write your content. After that, close your tag name. Close means forward slash, after that tag name. This is indicate that end tag is indicate that start tag. It is the your content. An HTML element is everything from the start tag to the end tag. Okay, in that H1 it is start tag, end tag. It is start tag, it is end tag. In that between we write your you want to which content you display on that web page, that will be written. My first heading, this is my first paragraph. Okay, there are two types are there, pair tag, unpaired tag. What is my pair tag? A tag is said to be pair tag if the text is placed between a tag. And what is mean by unpaired tag? An unpaired tag does not have a closing tag. Okay, what for example, this is the pair tag. Okay, H1, P, I also. Because in that start tag and end tag will be there. But in a BR means break, HR means horizontal line. Okay, this are no end tag, so it is said as the unpaired tag. Clear? The start tag contain element contain an a tag h1 br sorry p okay br is no any element contain or no any end tag means br tag as using which purpose for break the your contents or break that line that use the br tag after that html editors a simple text editor is all you need to learn the html learn html using notepad okay html editor means in that point clear the how to write the html code after that how to write save run okay and which editor are used for note html which notepad sorry which editor are used to write the html code or html language using notepad okay notepad editor in a you learn this programming in c or op or dsu which editor is used turbo c or turbo c++ this like in a html which editor is used notepad clear web page can be created and modified by using the professional html editors however the learning html we recommended a simple text editor like notepad okay. Using a simple text editor is good way to learn the html follow the steps below to create your first web page with notepad step 1 open notepad okay how to open this notepad okay windows 8 or later okay in your operating system okay in your pc or laptop your operating system is windows 8 or later how to open this open the start menu okay sorry open the start screen the windows symbol at the bottom left on your screen okay and type there notepad open it otherwise your window okay or your operating system is windows 7 or earlier then open start programs accessories notepad okay all are familiar with computer pc so all are open it the notepad steps 2 write some html code write or copy the following html code on into the notepad okay this is your simple code in that not the use the head mode head tag only for html and the body because body is used because actually which contents are displayed on your web page that will be write in a body tag and head tag is used for only for heading purpose okay heading purpose means giving the title name that's like to use that head tag let's save the html page how will we save the file in your computer select the file save okay save in a notepad menu okay with the name for example giving the name index.html okay what is the extension given html okay in a c language you give the code sorry extension .c that's in a op.cpp that's in that what is the giving the file extension .html okay what is meant by html what is meant by file extension okay all are know file extension means which type of that file extension is indicate that which type of that file okay .c means it is a c file .html means it is a html file .docx means document file .exe means it is a excel sheet file that's like okay after that view the html page in your browser how to that run that your html file open the saved html file in your favorite browser any your favorite browser sorry favorite browser double click on the file or right click and choose your open with the result will be look much like this like in your code use h1 is the heading p is the paragraph so display the inner my first heading my first paragraph will be displayed my first heading my first paragraph okay this is the fourth step clear that means how to create your how to run or how to write the html code open notepad file write your code save to .html how to run that files right click open with your which you want to browser that using through open it. Okay, when that open it, that your web page will be displayed. Means that we run that program only for opening it, means in a notepad this open, but using through when we opened it web browser, that time it converted in a web page. Okay, because web page websites are open with web browser. Web browser is the editor of that website or that web pages. Okay. Next point, HTML attributes. What is meant by attributes? All HTML elements can have attributes. Okay. Attributes provides additional information about elements. Attributes are always specified in the start tag. Okay, where they specify in a start tag. Attributes usually come in name or values pairs, like name is equal to in double quotation value. Okay, which are the HTML attributes are there? The href attribute. Okay, the a tag defines a hyperlink. Okay, it means which href is a attribute and there in which tag is used a tag. Okay, the href attribute specifies the URL of the page the link goes to. Example, a href means using href attribute specify that URL of that page. Okay, the syntax in your language, in a C language, say as it is a syntax. What is the syntax? That name. Okay, name is which attributes are used, that attribute name is equal to their value. Okay, and these are right in a start tag. In a is the tag is used for your href attributes, for href attribute purpose. Is which purpose is used attribute? For the hyperlinking purpose. Okay, a tag href is a name of attribute and in double quotation value. For example, https www.google.com means it is a Google page is open. Visit to your Google page and your tag will be closed. Clear that? Means a tag is used for hyperlink, and in that hyperlink href is attribute for specify that URL on that web page. Okay. Next attribute, dot src attribute. Okay, the img tag is used to embed an image in an HTML page. Okay, means src is specify, the src attribute specifies the path to the image to be displayed. What is the purpose of that src attribute? Using this specify the path to the image. Okay, and image tag is used to display your image. So in that write in a image tag which attribute is used. Src attribute is equal to value, means that address, that path will be shown. Okay, for example, I am display the any image, so that image name dot jsp, that file, that image extension, these are the value and src is the attribute and img is the tag. Okay, src attribute purpose is that specify the path of the image. Where that attribute is used? In a img tag, because in that attribute is provide the additional information about the element. Elements means your that tag. Okay, that additional information that will be displayed on using that attributes. Next attribute, the width and height attributes. The img tag should also contain the width and height attributes, which specify the width and height of that of the image in a pixels, giving the values that are values in a pixels. For example, img src is equal to that image name, width is equal to value and height is equal to value, name is equal to value, name is equal to value, attribute name is equal to values. Clear that? Width and height. What is meant by width and height? You already know. In using through height and width, through that image height and width are adjust. Okay. Next, ALT attribute. The required ALT attribute for the img tag specifies an alternate text for an image if the image for some reason cannot be displayed. This can be due to slow connection or an error in the src attribute, or if the user uses a screen reader. Clear that? Example means, or ALT, it is one type for attribute where to use in a img tag. Okay, what is the purpose of ALT attribute? Okay, when in your web page you display the you want to display the image, then which tag is used? IMG tag. And on that web page, how to display that image using that image path? Okay, how to give that image path using src attribute? Okay, in case that src attribute through that image will be not displayed, that time alt attribute is used. Means using two alt attributes, this content will be displayed. In that, what is the content will be displayed? Means alternative text will be displayed. What is the text is displayed? Girl with a jacket. What is the indicate that girls with a jacket means what? In a image, one girl is there and that they girl will be in a wear the jacket. So in that, using through that sentence, we imagine that which type of image that will be displayed on that web page. That time to use alt attribute. Clear that? What is the said? In case any connection slow or any error on that src attribute, that time user uses the screen reader. Okay, uses that read that sentence is reader that girls with a jacket. That's to thinking that user in on that web page. I think that image will be displayed and that image in a one girl and that are wear the jacket. Clear that? Means alternative text. Okay, alt means alternative text for that image. When not display the image, that time using through sentence we you understanding which image will be show displayed. Okay, after that, the style attribute. What is the purpose of the style attribute? The style attributes is used to add a styles on an element such as color, font, size or any more. Okay, for example, P is the tag name, style is the attribute name, is equal to value. For example, value are given color colon red. Okay, this is the red paragraph. Okay, these all points are already completed in your previous semester language on subject are there, HTML subject, but in that multimedia, in the multimedia, in under the multimedia subject, this is the HTML one type of chapter, but is the chapter is already language or already all one type of subject or one type of course you already learn in a previous semester. So I am only for headings or repetition purpose that I taken that all our points. Okay, you easily understanding these points because these are all are completed in your previous semester. But for the direct secondary students and for the change the trade that students there understanding purpose, I'm once again revision it. Also first year students also that revision it. HTML headings. HTML headings are titles or subtitles that you want to display on a web page. For example, heading 1, heading 2, these are the, okay, heading 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, these are the HTML headings means what? Title or subtitle. Okay, when you want any to display the subtitle or title, that time to use HTML headings. Okay, HTML headings are defined with the H1 to H6 tags. In that 6 tags are used H1 to H6. H1 tag defines the most important heading and H6 is defined as the least important headings. Also the size will be, you clear that H1 heading size will be high as compared to H6. Okay, means how to H1, H2, H3 are start, that the size will be reduced. Clear? Example, H1 heading 1, H2, H3, these code when we write, that after that which output will be displayed? This output will be displayed. Okay, these are the example. It is a start tag, it is the end tag. Okay, we already completed the tag. Start tag, end tag. Okay, what is the difference between start and end tag? The slash, forward slash are there that indicate that it is the end tag. It is the start tag. Okay, after that, heading attributes. What is the attributes? What is meant by attributes? Additional information of that tag. Okay, H1 is indicate that headings, but additional information is that heading in a center or left or right, that are said using through attributes. And which attributes is used? Align. clear that? What is meant by attributes? Additional information of that tag. Clear? The align attributes specifies the horizontal alignment of a heading. Their align values are left, right or center. Okay. Attributes, the syntax is that name is equal to in double quotation value. Okay, which value? Left, right or center. Examples, I am clear that when display the, when run that code, that time SIT, after that IT and SYIT. Okay. First H1 is used, so their headings, their size is biggest. Okay, after that is the small, after that small, dislike will be display the output. Clear that? Okay, summary on that today's lecture. In this lectures we start the point introduction to HTML in under what is meant by web page, web browser, what is the HTML, after that HTML page structure means how to write that HTML code in your notepad. Okay, after that HTML elements, that means what? HTML elements are also said as the HTML tags. After that HTML editors means how to that type in a, means which editor is used for HTML language, how to save it, how to run it, that's like. After that HTML attributes, attributes means additional information about that element. After that HTML headings, how to give the title, subtitle in a HTML page. Okay, these points are taken on today's lecture. Homework for you, write in your notebook that on today's lectures points. Okay, these are the only for practical subject, no theory exam, so I am not any given the assignment, but these all points are complete, write in your notebook. When you reach in your college, that time I am checking, and it is also assessing you for your term works marks, so not ignore this subject. Okay, here stop on today's lecture. In this lecture, any doubts are arise, then contact with me. Thank you.